Today, I'll give you the ultimate guide to build your career in data science. I'm Samanvay, a data scientist living in Sydney, Australia. Getting into data science is a very confusing process. Data science is so broad and there's so many ways of getting into it. So I'll break it down as simply as I can. And I'll try to give you a framework that you can use to build your career in data science. Let's start from the very basics. Currently, there's four different roles you can do in data science. Being a data scientist, data engineer, machine learning engineer, and a data analyst. To be successful in any of the four professions, you need a varying combination of 8 different skill categories. In my opinion, these 8 skill categories are definitive in being a data science practitioner. Here are the 8 categories: statistics, machine learning, data engineering, data analysis, data visualization, data leadership, stakeholder management, and communications. In terms of building your data science career, there's 3 phases to it. Let's start from the very beginning. Phase 1 is learning data science. Let's say that you're someone that wants to get into data science but isn't really sure what step to take. You'll fall into one of 3 categories. You'll either be a high school student, a bachelor student, or a mid-career transitioner. For the high school student, your best bet is to study a Bachelor of Computer Science with a specialization in data science. This gives you the best foundation to get started in data science. If you're more curious of the bachelor's option, then check out this video I did recently reviewing all of the bachelor's degree in Australia that prepares you well for data science. For the bachelor student, you've got 2 options. The first is to pursue a Master of Data Science, and the second is to do self-study of data science and try to get a job in the field. Now, the first option of pursuing a Master's of Data Science is best for people that are coming from a non-STEM background or are looking to immigrate into Australia, or if you prefer a more structured way of learning data science. The second way is to self-study data science. Now, this works really well if you've already got a STEM degree and you've got some mathematical and computer science foundations. Then you can get away with learning data science on your own. And then you can leverage the skills you've learned to get a job in data science. For people that are looking for a mid-career transition into data science, there's a couple of options available to you. So the first option is clearly you can go off and do a Master of Data Science, which is a good way of starting from a clean slate. And again, this is applicable to you if you're coming from a field that is very much non-STEM and very different to data science. This could be a good starting point. The other option is if you're already working for a company, which is maybe a tech company which has a data science division, you could try to leverage your skills to get a position in that data science team. But this would mean that you're starting from a more junior position. And in another case, if you're transitioning from a very much a STEM related field like engineering, then I think the best approach is to self-study data science in your own time and try to leverage those skills to try to secure a data science position. Because I know a lot of people that have switched from software engineering into data science, and their engineering skills is highly valuable when they're making that switch. So try to figure out which of the 8 skill categories you already possess, because potentially it means that you can leverage those existing skills to secure a job in the data science field. And if you'd like to go down the self-study route, I recently made a 3-month roadmap to study data science. I'll post a link to the video here. Phase 2 of building a career in data science involves getting a data job. The best way to get jobs is through referrals. This means doing industry internships, doing research projects with your professors if you're still studying, and meeting as many data professionals as you can through your personal networks or through industry networking events. Leverage your unique skills and try to stand out as much as you can. Reach out to people you find interesting on LinkedIn. The hardest part of phase 2 is getting your foot in the door. And it's okay if your first job is a little bit different to what you thought you might work as. So for example, if you wanted to be a data scientist, it's okay that your first job is a data analyst. But once you get that first job, you'll get more opportunities to grow as you level up in your career. Phase 3 is really where it gets very interesting. It's about career growth. So you've finally got a job in data. Now the fun bit starts. Remember those 8 skill categories I talked about earlier? Now your task is to figure out which of the 8 categories you enjoy and the ones that you're good at. These 8 skill categories will help you figure out where you want to specialize in your data science career. When looking for new job opportunities, you need to use these 8 skill categories to figure out which job opportunity to take. For example, in my first job, I learned data engineering, statistics, and communications. And for my second job, I wanted to learn more machine learning. So I went ahead and found a job that allowed me to upskill in that particular skill category. Then for my third job, I wanted to upskill my stakeholder management skills as well as my data leadership skills. So I went ahead and found a job that helped me level up those skill categories. I call this approach the skill maximization framework. This allows you to search for a job based on the skills you want to work on, rather than a salary or particular position. For me, in the first half of my career, I did quite a lot of engineering. Whilst I really enjoyed doing the technical work and getting down in the weeds, I quickly realized that I enjoyed talking to customers and doing stakeholder management a little bit more. This phase is also about learning how to create opportunities for yourself within a company. For example, in my first job, I really wanted to learn a little bit more about how customers used our products that I was working on. So I volunteered to go to customer meetings simply by asking. And through that process, I quickly learned about my passion for helping customers and talking to them. So these 8 skill categories will help you become more aware of your strengths and weaknesses. So as I mentioned, focus more on honing the skill sets that you really enjoy doing and that you're good at. So focus on learning before maximizing your monetary outcomes. That's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, then smash that like button and I'll see you next time.